Today the brother comes on to thee. Now he starts looking at everyone. These people are kuffar. These people are lost. These people are going to hellfire. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Who died and made you the prophet, man? The prophet never did that. Every one of you is lost except whom I guide. Allah doesn't need anyone. Don't ever think, my brother, you know, people now walking around, Allahu Akbar, the brother goes to Hajj. When he comes back, you can't call him Muhammad anymore. It's Hajj Muhammad. Brother, I've been to Hajj. So please, if you don't mind, you call me Hajj Muhammad. Really? Really? What, you think that because you performed Hajj that you equal to something now in Allah's eyes? Is this the arrogance you have with Allah? And people get upset. Brother, I didn't spend $10,000 and sacrifice my family for 4 weeks only to return, and you call me Muhammad? That's Hajj Muhammad. The Prophet of Allah in the authentic hadith, speaking to Sahaba, speaking to the greatest ummah that ever walked the earth, speaking to your fathers, speaking to a ummah that happily gave their lives for the pleasure of Allah. People who did the utmost, the biggest sacrifices, and they deemed themselves as the most insignificant people. Today you do nothing and you think you're up there. They did everything and they thought that they were down there. The Prophet of Allah speaking to them, he says, none of you, who's he speaking to? He says, none of you will enter Jannah through your actions. None. People walking around like he's already from the people of Jannah, mashallah. People now, they worship the mashayikh. 100% brother, these people. This guy's from Firdaus al-A'la. The Prophet of Allah saying to Sahaba, none of you will enter Jannah through your actions. None. So they asked the Prophet of Allah, even you? He says, yeah, even me. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest mujahid was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest teacher was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest father was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest husband was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest mercy to humanity was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest abid to ever worship Allah Azza wa Jal was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest messenger to ever walk the earth was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest prophet to ever receive revelation was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The greatest creation that Allah ever created was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says, even me. Except and only if Allah Azza wa Jal was to show mercy upon me. Even me. And people walking around like they're something, man. Prophet of Allah tells us of a man who worshipped Allah for 500 years. 500 years he worshipped Allah. And then when he stood before Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells the angels, take him and enter him into the paradise through my mercy. So the man says, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh Allah. And more or less he says, oh Allah, well, I appreciate the offer. Couldn't help but hear that you said you want me to enter through your mercy. Oh Allah, I don't want to enter through your mercy. I want to enter through my actions, oh Allah. Oh Allah, I worship you for 500 years. For 500 years, oh Allah, I worship you. So I don't want to enter through your mercy. I paid my debt. I worked hard. Every day I worship you, ya Allah. I want to enter through my actions. Allah says, you want to enter through your actions? Fine. No problems. So Allah Azza wa Jal orders the angels. He says to them, bring the scales here. He says, put the man's 500 years of worship on one end of the scale. And put, only put, just put the blessing that I gave him, the ni'mah that I gave him, to be able to see with his eyes, just that, nothing more, nothing more. Just put the blessing that I gave him to be able to see with his eyes, put that on the other end of the scale. Just the blessing to be able to see outweighed 500 years of worship. So Allah says to the angels, take him and throw him into the hellfire. Then and only then, he says, oh Allah, please, oh Allah, please, I am content with your mercy. I'm content with your mercy, Ya Allah. Allah doesn't need anyone, my brothers. The ni'mah of seeing. Today we've forgotten. Today we've forgotten. Today you and I think what? That to see, I need a pair of eyes. You're wrong. Because there are millions around the world that have eyes, but they can't see. It is Allah that allows you to see. Today you think to hear, I need a pair of ears. You're wrong. Because there are millions around the world that have ears. They're stuck on their heads, but they can't hear, my brother. It is Allah that allows you to hear. Today you think to walk, I need a pair of legs. You're wrong. There are millions around the world that have legs, but they can't walk. It is Allah and Allah alone that allows you to walk. Allah, not you. Allah, not you. Allah doesn't need you, my brother. Allah doesn't need me. Allah doesn't need us. And we have to understand, because this is aqidah. You have to know this so that when you worship, you are always humble. When you worship him, you never have pride. When you worship him, you never have arrogance. Because you know, at any given point in time, I am where I am only through his mercy. Only through his rahmah, I am where I am. Not because of your own actions. And to know with depth, with yaqeen, with certainty, that Allah, the King of Kings, doesn't need anyone. He doesn't need anyone, my brothers. Wallahi, everything you see around you, everything. Today, the Muslims have so much fear in their hearts. Fear. Fear of the kuffar. Fear of the West. Fear of regulations. Fear of this and fear of that. But to know that Allah Azza wa Jal is not in need. Wallahi, my brothers, wallahi, I take an oath by Allah. You have to come to terms. You have to come to believe with certainty that every single human being who ever lived, whoever's living, and whoever is to come and live on this earth, wallahi, every single human being, every single jinn, every single animal that walks on this earth, every single bird that takes the flight in the sky, every single fish that swims in the oceans of Allah Azza wa Jal, wallahi, every single land, every single country, wallahi, with all their governments and all their military force and all their might and all their science and all their money, all with the exception of none, every country, every tree, every grain of sand, every mountain, every river, every ocean, wallahi, every star, every sun, every moon, every single planet, every single angel, the billions and billions and billions of angels, all of them, with the exception of none, Mikael, Jibreel, Israfil, all, the first heaven, the second heaven, the third heaven, the fourth heaven, the fifth heaven, the sixth heaven, the seventh heaven, the ocean above it, the eight that carry the throne of Allah, the arch of Allah, all are dead, all are dead. Nothing moves, nothing stops, nothing makes, nothing breaks, nothing gives, nothing takes, nothing rises, and nothing falls, nothing harms, and nothing benefits, illallah. And until this, yaqeen and faith is in your heart. That nothing. That everything is dead. Everything. Except Allah. Allah doesn't need anything. Anyone. No prophet. No angels. No jinn. No ants. We need him. He's Al-Hayyul Qayyum. He's the ever living. So you might say, brother, I'm alive. What's so special about that? I'm living. Yeah, but your living is dependent on his existence. He's the first with no beginning. He's the last with no ending. He's Allah. He is Allah. Al-Malik. The Prophet of Allah sitting with Sahaba, sitting with the greatest ummah that ever walked the earth. The greatest ummah that ever walked the earth. Authentic hadith. And this is the wala, my opinion, or the opinion of the ulama and the mashayikh. Allah sends down Quran speaking about Sahaba. He says, I am pleased with them and they are pleased with me. The Prophet of Allah in the authentic hadith. Tune in, huh? Tune in. In the authentic hadith, the Prophet of Allah sitting with Sahaba, he says to them, I see what you don't see, and I hear what you don't hear. He says, أطت السماء وحق لها أن تأط. He says, the heavens have squeaked, and they have every right to squeak. So Sahaba are amazed. What do you mean, O Prophet of Allah? What do you mean that the heavens have squeaked? What do you mean that the seven heavens have squeaked? You know, my brothers, because mashallah, today we've become a people of science and logic, you know. Everything we know about astronomy is not even 1% of what's really out there. And our solar system, our galaxy, is one of millions and millions that are out there. And in our solar system alone, in our galaxy alone, one of the scholars was saying, he says, there are so many stars in our galaxy alone. I'm not going to tell you what's, ours is one of millions. So never mind the millions, our one alone. He says, in our galaxy alone, there are so many stars, you know, the sun is one of the smaller stars that are in our galaxy. And the sun alone is millions and millions of times bigger than the earth. So the scholar is saying, if we were given 1 second to name every single star that is in our galaxy, you ready for this? You will need 300 trillion years and you wouldn't name every star that is in our galaxy. And all this is in Samawat al-Ula, is in the first heavens. The Prophet of Allah is saying the seven heavens have squeaked and they have every right to squeak. Why? Why, O Prophet of Allah? Why have they squeaked? You know, sometimes you put a lot of weight onto something, so it starts making noise. It starts giving way because it can't carry the load. The Prophet of Allah says the seven heavens can no longer carry the load. The load of what? He says, "Ma fi mawdi' arba asabi'." There isn't room in all these heavens for four fingers. Except there is an angel in prostration to Allah. And you think Allah needs your money on the way out, huh? You think Allah cares whether you pray or you don't? There isn't room for four fingers in all the heavens except there is an angel in prostration to Allah. Angels, from the moment they're created to the moment they stand before Allah, one continuous sajda. They never did anything else. One continuous sajda for billions of years. Yet when they stand before Allah, they say, oh Allah, forgive us. Forgive us, Ya Allah, for we did not give haq to your ibadah. We didn't give rights. We didn't worship you the way you should be worshipped. And you and I think that Allah needs us. People walking around with a big chip on his shoulder with an attitude. My brothers, Allah Azza wa Jalla doesn't need anyone. Allah doesn't need anyone. In the hadith Qudsi, in the authentic hadith, Allah Azza wa Jalla he says, Ya Ibadi, I'm my slaves. Every single one of you is hungry, except whom I feed. Every one of you is hungry, except whom I feed. Today, when you go to buy a meal, you think, I bought this meal. No, you're wrong. Allah fed you. So people start looking at their meals, and he starts having pride and arrogance. That I don't eat this, and I don't eat that. I only eat specific foods. Brother, it's Allah that feeds you. Allah says, oh my slaves, every one of you, with the exception of none, every one of you is naked except whom I clothe. Today the brother buys a Gucci hat or a Louis Vuitton bag, Allahu Akbar, but you can't give him salams anymore. You can't give him salams. There used to be a time when, you know, the boys used to wear Nikes. No, we don't wear Nikes anymore. We wear Lacoste and Gucci shoes and Louis Vuitton shoes because I'm a cut above the rest. And pride and arrogance, and he feels and he believes that I'm something. Allahu Akbar. Now all of your wealth has become what your shoes are. What? So if your shoes are something, then you're something. Now the Muslims, he looks at his clothes and his watch and the car he drives, then he judges where he fits in society. He says, oh my slaves, every one of you is naked except whom I clothe. And oh my slaves, every single one of you is lost except whom I guide.